Heidi ho, YouTubers. I had to go to a conference last week for work. And we went to the big city. Well, we got a few preps while we're out. A few other things that weren't preps, but we got a few preps, so I thought I'd show them to you real quick. My rhubarb patch out there is getting a little thin, and I'm going to divide them and stuff this spring, but I thought maybe I'll throw some seeds in too, so I got that. This is from Seed Savers Exchange. Mrs. New America Mel, like this. Mrs. GoatHollow kind of went crazy, and we went to a organic food store. They had $17 for a chicken in there, for a broiler chicken. Drove me nuts. Anyhow, got some mugwort. This is all for Mrs. GoatHollow's herbal medicine cabinet, you know. Mugwort and slippery elm bark. I don't know what she's going to do with all this stuff. It's kind of her bag, the herbal stuff. Black cohosh, mullein leaf, and ginger root, and some ginseng powder. Okay, cool. And we got to go to Army Surplus Store, browse through. They were pretty expensive too, but I did. Oh wait, these are from that store too. From the health food store. I'm gonna put rubbing alcohol on these. They're for. I'm gonna make up a couple more penny stove kits. Anyhow, the Army Surf. Well, we'll start somewhere else. On the way back, we went to a Amish store. And remember on the turkey and nudies video, I was talking about how maybe we ought to stock up on some cornstarch to get at least a bucket full. Well, I got a start on it. And Amish store had some great deals, man. I said I was going to have to go back because it's not near time to plant potatoes where I live yet, but they had 25-pound bag of seed potatoes for $15. Just a hell of a deal. Oh, Mrs. GoatHollow went to Barnes & Noble while I was in the boring conference. And she got a book, Making It, Radical Home Ec for the Post-Consumer World. I've only leafed through it a little bit, but it looks way cool. What else did we get? At the Amish store, there was some activity going on back at the dairy counter. And by the time I got back there, they only had 8 pounds. I used one, so I'm substituting for you guys. This one's from our regular grocery store, but 8 pounds of butter, which $1.99 a pound. I'd bought a case if they'd had it, but I got the last of it. And oh, we went to Lowe's while we were out. I got me a plant light for some of my vegetable starts for the garden. Start my seeds pretty soon. And we went to a Army Surplus Store, and I got 100 feet of 550 paracord, and it's an odd thing to have in the Army Surplus Store, but had 5 yards of cheesecloth in here. I don't know how wide it is. It was only $4. And I picked up 3 P38s. I gave one to GoatHollow Jr. And I've carried this one on my key ring for a long time. Look at that. I did put tape on that just for you guys, because that tells exactly what fire department I belong to. Anyhow, I keep the rubber band on here because sometimes my keys wind up in my pocket, front pocket, and this will open up, and it's real sharp and pokey, and there's places near my front pocket I do not want poked. I've seen people with huge keychains, people talking about their EDC keychain on YouTube, and this is about all I carry, because I was read you're not supposed to put too much weight on the ignition of your car, so, but I always do carry my Altoid 10 survival kit. I posted a video on that. No, I'm not going to give you a link. Go look for it and don't be lazy. And I always carry a flashlight. And I have a get home bag in the car. But I always thought everybody had to know what a P38 was. And they got a bigger cousin, I think. What is it? P51, P52, something in there. And pretty simple deal. But I was talking to somebody the other day about how we picked some up at the Army Surplus store. They'd never heard of one. So I'm sure they didn't know how to use one. I got a can of pears out of the pantry. So I thought I'd take just a minute, show you how they work. They're not really expensive. I think they cost me like 50 cents a piece. If you might want to get some, you know, for your bug up bag or something. What if you come across a house and they got canned goods, but you can't find a can opener anywhere? So that would be a real bummer. Because I've tried to open cans with a pocket knife, and it's not any fun at all. If you got an Army Surplus near you, and just go pick some up. Hell, 50 cents a piece. If you don't have an Army Surplus, I found some on Amazon, and I put them on my Amazon store for you. Like 5 of them for $4. But pretty simple little device. Cheap. Doesn't weigh much as a dime, and maybe you ought to have some in your bug out bag or your EDC. So anyhow, me and Mr. Fork here, we got business to attend to. We'll get through this.